All right, so let's start by exploring our schemas. We'll understand how exactly our house model has changed now that it's been brought into the iTwin platform. Now here's a list of all the schemas. We talked about how there's some common schemas that are used by most infrastructure domains and applications, such as a house or a roadway that we saw. So here's a list of all the common schemas, and then there can be specialized schemas that pertain to individual data sets or applications. In this case, the house schema is our specialized schema. Now, the first thing we need to understand is that anything in BIS can either be a schema, a class, or a property. And schemas contain a list of classes, which contain a list of properties. And properties are what actually contain our instance data that we're seeking. For example, in this case, the smart devices. Now, first, let's look at a basic BIS class. So we'll go under BIS core and look for geometric element 3D. So I got it right here. Now this is a pretty commonly used class. Pretty much any model that contains 3D data is going to contain a geometric element 3D type element. So we'll click on this class and we'll get a list of properties for this class. So you can see here are some properties that we expect a geometric element 3D to contain. We have a bounding box, low and high, geometry stream, origin. And then we also have some properties that are defined in the element class. And user label is one of them, code value. So why do we have properties from another class in this particular class? That's because in BIS, everything is defined through hierarchies. So there's a hierarchy of classes here. And the idea is that once we've already defined some properties that are going to be used in other classes, why not just inherit the properties for that class rather than having to redefine them each time we define a new class? So for example, in this case, geometric element 3D inherits from the element class, and that's why it contains the properties for the element class. And the goal here is to organize our data in an efficient way. Now from here, we can look for our smart device properties. For that, there's a really nice search feature here where we can start typing in our property that we're looking for. So we're looking for a smart device. Here is a smart device class. Now you can see that it belongs to the DGN custom item types house schema, and the smart device is our class. And here's a list of all the properties. And you can see here's smart device ID and smart device type, the two properties that we saw in our DGN file when looking for our smart devices. And you can also see that we have properties from physical element, geometric element 3D. So in terms of the hierarchy, smart device inherits from physical element, which inherits from spatial element, which inherits from geometric element 3D, and finally all the way back to element. All right, so now that we have the target schema, class, and the properties that we're looking for, we can actually query some instance data and get a list of our smart devices. So let's do that in the next lesson.